Dolphins who have come to us from the Florida Keys and Dolphin Connection. Their names are Chinook and Rainier. You're going to see how our trainers use training to help these new animals acclimate to their surroundings and to care for all the animals here at Seven Seas. Ladies and gentlemen, here he is, 18-year-old Rainier. Give him a big round of applause.
Ha, ha, ha.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, both Chinook and Rainier have only been here for 8 short weeks. But in that amount of time, our trainers have been using a positive reinforcement training technique to help these animals adjust to their new surroundings by training them on new behaviors. For example, one of our trainers has been working with Chinook on something known as a long backwards tail walk. Take a look to the left of the pool. If Chinook rises up and starts to ride, remembers that behavior, he wants to see if he can actually stay up a little bit longer. Take a look to the left. There he comes. That's Chinook. Now, if you notice how Chinook returned to normal, he did reward him with a mouthful of fish. With the positive reinforcement training technique, every time our trainers ask the dolphins for a behavior, they will reward the correct behavior with a mouthful of fish, sometimes ice chips, or even a squirt in the mouth with some fresh water in the squirt bottle that you see on stage. But they will also use this training technique to practice behaviors that Chinook and Rainier learned down in Dolphin Connection. For example, we're going to see if Chinook and Rainier will show you the 3 sets of fins that all dolphins possess while I tell you what these fins do. On the underside of the body, you will see their pectoral fins. Now the dolphins use their pectoral fins to steer themselves left and right as they swim in the water. But on the dolphin's back is a large fin shaped like a triangle. Watch as Mark and Jackie point out the dorsal fins. Now the dorsal fin acts like a keel on a boat, keeping the dolphin moving in a straight line even when they swim at high rates of speed. Last but not least, let's take a look at those large and powerful tail fins coming up now. Now by pumping their tail flips in an up and down motion, the dolphins can create all the power they need for swimming, for jumping, and even for catching fish. That's right, I said the dolphins can use their tails to help them catch fish. For example, we want you to look at a hunting strategy the dolphins use that is known as tail lobbing. Now that was Rainier. Take a look at Chinook on your left. Now the sound that results from the dolphin's tail hitting the water travels downward. These sounds scare passing fish so that the fish will group so tightly together that the dolphin then can open its mouth wide, swim through the middle of this group of fish, and swallow as many as it would like. That's very important because one adult dolphin, Chinook and Rainier size, can eat up to 35 pounds of fish each and every day. Now, the most important use of our positive reinforcement training technique is to make sure the dolphins receive the best care possible. Our trainers can use this technique to practice behaviors such as this fluke presentation. Now, from this position, the dolphin voluntarily presents its tail fluke to the trainer, who can locate blood vessels on the underside. They can swab the area with alcohol and use a syringe to withdraw a small blood sample. That blood sample is then taken to our Brookfield Zoo Animal Hospital, where our vets will look at the findings to assure that the dolphins are always in excellent health. But that's just one of many husbandry behaviors the trainers practice with the dolphins every day. For example, take a look at this behavior known as a layout. Now from the layout position, our trainers can check over the dolphin's entire body. They can check the dolphin's sensitive skin, and all of our dolphins are trained to receive an ultrasound from this position, so our trainers can check their internal organs and make sure that everything is fine. Longer periods of time out during our presentations, but I think they did a first great job for the first part of the show. Thank you so much for the year. Just a few moments, we're going to introduce you to our two female dolphins, both of whom are long-term residents of the Seven Seas family. But before we do that, we want to introduce you to one more new animal here at Seven Seas. Take a look to the right-hand side of the stadium. You're going to see our trainer, Greg, coming out with a 4-year-old Harris hog on his blood. This Harris hog's name is Pachara. And being a Harris hog, Pachara is a bird of prey, which means that she does hunt and eat meat. Now, Greg will be using that same positive reinforcement training technique to reward Saguaro with small pieces of meat if she stays calm and perched on his log. Now, part of her training will require that she does come and close to say hi. Give her a big round of applause. Now, a while ago, you saw Mark working on that long backwards tail walk behavior with Chinook. He's also training that behavior to Kaylee, but he's been working with Kaylee a bit longer on this behavior. Now, you're going to see Mark is at the right-hand side of the pool. Jackie's given Kaylee her target. Let's see what Kaylee is capable of. Take a look to your right. Now, as you can see, Mark's been working with this behavior just a bit longer with Kaylee. She's supporting her entire body weight over about 50% of the pool's water surface. Now, Kaylee's been asked to do this one more time. Let's see how she does. For doing so well with that behavior. But one of the most beautiful behaviors anybody can ever see a dolphin do is something known as breaching. Breaching is a behavior that scientists think dolphins will use to help communicate their location over long distances in the ocean. Now, I could go on and on trying to describe to you what a breach looks like, but take a look to your left. Here comes Topeka with a breach. The scientists think that the loud sound resulting from the dolphin's body hitting the water is what enabled them to communicate their thing that is just a way for the dolphins to scratch an itchy spot on their back. Now, dolphins are noted for having some of the most amazing eyesight out of all the marine mammals. Their eyesight allows them to clearly see through the surface line of the water, something that people can't do. To demonstrate this, take a look to your right and look up. You're going to see a white target coming down from the ceiling. We're going to ask Topeka and Kaylee to go underneath the surface of the water, spot that tether ball, launch themselves out, and take a tap. Topeka's been asked to start the game off. Let's see how she does. Now, she did a great job, but she made the game far more challenging for Kaylee, who has to use her learned timing and coordination so she can hit a moving target. Because our eyes aren't strong enough to compensate for the distortion at the surface line of the water. After our presentation, is there an underwater viewing gallery? Look through the windows and see if you can have those targets as well as the dolphins. Let's give them a big round of applause for showing up the back. Built upon cooperation and trust. To demonstrate this, I'd like for everybody to take a look to their left and Mark on the island. Give Mark a big wave. Mark's heading into the water now to demonstrate the cooperation and trust that he shares with both Topeka and Kaylee. Let's take a look.